she finally is, my fire trap slash frostblink elementalist league starter for 3.21 crucible league. Where's the gear? That's what we're going to focus on right now. I've just sent more instead of the 10% more that a lot of other skills get now. And we'll go when we talk about amulets, we'll see in a second. You only really care about getting fire trap to level 30. More of that is kind of a waste of resources. And so it gets more than I think almost any other skill in the game for damage per level. It gets like 15% more instead of the 10% more that a lot of other skills get. Fire trap, when you throw it, and I have an MTX that makes it look kind of bluish, but it will leave a burning ground on the ground when it activates. And this burning ground, let's see, burning ground is 13 million on the burning ground. The ignite is another 21 million. Ignite's actually most of it. So we're kind of taking advantage. It's not exactly double dipping, but we're able to scale both the burning ground and the ignite. We're doing two different damages over time at the same time, and we're able to scale both of those at the same time. As soon as we get the fire trap to level 30, the number one priority with gearing your character is getting your fire trap to level 30. And the way that we do this is the easiest thing is a skin of lords. Also, you can do things, and we'll show this when we go over the body armor specifically. We can very, very easily craft a +1/+1 body armor. I bought both of these bases this morning for 5 and 10 chaos each. This is a very, very easy craft. I bought these bases already like this. I didn't even have to roll for it. And you can alteration spam if you want to. We can go for a +1/+1, which is almost as good as the skin of lords. We just want to get fire trap to level 30. That's the number one goal. So, you know, we can put empower in there, all that, whatever gets it to level 30. After that, and this is where the scepters come into play, all we really care about scaling, and this is why the scepters are cheaper than for other builds that may be using fire trap or similar skills, is it is actually very easy for us to hit a level 30 fire trap, and we don't need more levels. We don't need to roll our scepters for +1 fire, +1 all, go for those fractures or anything like that. I actually bought this base this morning for a grand total of one divine. And there were dozens available. And obviously, if the demand goes up, this build is very popular. Beginning of the league, that may be very expensive. But you can go for any fractured suffix or even no fracture and just spam single scorched fossils. That's all you have to do until you're happy with suffixes. Then you can craft fire damage or increase damage over time on the prefix. Even better would be something like suffixes can't be changed, use a veiled chaos orb, and try to get that increased fire damage on the prefix. But you can have a stepping stone scepter for very, very little investment, even in soul self-found friendly. Worst case, even if you don't have scorched fossils, you know, you can do reforged fire right here. Purple juice is purple juice is the cheapest juice. No one wants that juice. It is not yellow juice, luckily. And you can even just do reforged fire. Not as good as scorched fossils, but you can do that. So yeah, you can use an essence of anguish here. So the flat fire damage does scale our ignite. You can do this until you're happy with your suffixes. And then you can just craft on the prefix, increase fire damage. And you can have a very, very good... So just essences of anguish until you have good suffixes. And then just craft damage over time or fire damage on the prefix. And you have a very, very good scepter. We can make it even cheaper. And that is the magic of the singularity. It has a very huge flat lightning damage to spells. And if you recall, we are using Shaper of Flames right here, which says all damage can ignite. And as long as we're doing more fire damage than any other element, that will turn into ignite. And that ignite damage will get scaled by all of our increased fire. So even if you ignite with lightning damage, the ignite that happens is fire damage. We don't care that this happens to be lightning damage, as long as the number for the flat damage on our skill is bigger for the fire than any other element. And that's all that matters. And then the key with the singularity is it starts up at base level 62 with the Platinum Scepter. You can set up your loot filter, and I will have a loot filter with the final build guide. I will have a customized one that comes along with the build. It's basically just a regular loot filter that is showing Platinum Scepters. Might be a couple other things that I look out for. But you can pick up Platinum Scepters, and they are very, very easy to chance. In 2 days of solo self-found, a few weeks ago, I made 5 singularities in 2 days of solo self-found. Very, very easy to get. Also has 100% increased damage with hits and ailments. So, and not to mention, increased cast speed and reduced mana cost of skills. At low, low level, this is really, really hard to beat. And 2 of these singularities, max price that I've ever seen a singularity, beginning of the league is 15 chaos. Even if that goes up, you can make your own. It's not that hard to make. You can chance it yourself. And it's not even the best in slot. Now, my friend has been testing this build from solo self-found, and he also called out a thing that he saw in the league announcement. I want to call this out. Is we saw this. Item sells for an additional unique of that base type. So in Crucible next week, you want to pick up every single Platinum Scepter. Like, if you're still looking for Singularities, pick up every single Platinum Scepter. Singularity is the only unique Platinum Scepter. So if you find that, guaranteed, 100%, easy peasy. It is going to be very, very easy to get. Chance Orbs are kind of valuable for early map progression, so you might not want to spend those, but you can just do that. That's a really great tip right there. I got all of my Void Stones with Singularity. It will carry you to about 5 million dot DPS, but that's about as far as it gets. That's what we want to start off with right there. After that, you're going to set up your trade searches. You're going to be looking for a Fractured Suffix, ideally. Fractured Dot Multi is the best. You can also go for Fractured Fire Damage on the prefix. That's not too bad. If you find Fractured plus Fire and your Fire Trap is not plus one yet, they're all good. This is the thing, is there's so much flexibility, and you can have 10, 15, 20 million DPS with scepters that are not as good as the one that I have here. And both of these scepters I crafted myself for about 4 to 8 divines. I don't remember exactly how many reforges I did or how many suffixes can be changed, but it was 4 to 8 divines for each one of these. These are very close to basically perfect in this build. They're just not that hard to craft. Obviously, the demand on the fracture will go up if the demand on the build is up, but any of these mods fractured is good for you. Fractured Burning Damage, Fractured Fire Dot Multi, Damage Over Time, you know, if you get a high flat fire damage to spells or increased fire damage on the prefix. Any of those are good, and then you just basically spam single Scorched Fossils. That is the easiest thing. Unfortunately, due to the nerf to Harvest, you can't, if you have extra yellow or purple juice, you can just do the purple juice. Because there is no Reforged Fire more common, it's like, it's not going to guarantee you more than one fire mod, right? So this is not the ideal way to do it. Plenty of ways to get fossils in the game right now. Everything from Heist, Expedition, Legion, like, I think literally all the content in the game gives you fossils better than Delve. But Delve is the, I think, only source, or by far the best source of Resonators. And Resonators do be getting kind of expensive these days, right? So here's what you do, is, where are the nodes? So you want to take the Delve nodes right here. This is the big one. Mining byproducts. Sulfite veins and chests in your maps have a 10% chance to contain an equal amount of azurite. And then you can also have sulfite infusion right here, which will grant you additional sulfite as well. This is not too necessary. And just having mining byproducts, you'll get tens and tens of thousands of azurite just per week passively. And all you have to do is then go to Nico, and you'll have, like, I think I did it for only a couple weeks, and I had like 200,000 azurite. And then you can just go to Nico, shift click, and then you can just buy resonators like this. And like, I didn't delve at all this league, and I was able to like almost fully upgrade everything just from doing the mining byproducts. Yeah, Delve is actually like the worst place for fossils. The one thing that is kind of weak that we don't mind but we don't care about is spell damage. Due to the way that Ignite works, spell damage does not scale the size of the Ignite. There is a special property that spell damage, you'll see right here, modifiers to spell damage apply to the Burning Ground, but it doesn't apply to the Ignite. So we just don't care about spell damage generally, but it's not bad to get. Really, all we're looking for here on the Scepter is good suffixes. But if I hit great prefixes, you know, I'm good on that. This is the cheapest way to craft like a decent scepter. You know, the ideal. All right, we're done. So anyway, it's really easy. It is really, really easy. Like, and this is good enough, right? This 100% just gets you going, right? This is an amazing starter scepter that this will take you to all of your Void Stones. And that's it. That's all you got to do, man. The Eye of Malice is a very special, awesome helmet for this build. The reason for that is this line entirely. We do not care about the exposure. One out of four times, it's fine. You can just do that. But, you know, your exposure is only going to be 1 out of 4 times. I don't like conditional damage as much. You know, I try to get it as reliable as possible, right? But if you want to go for a different implicit on your gloves, you can do that if you want to replace the fire exposure right there. But I don't like relying this. The reason why we use this helmet, nothing is even close. I have tested triple elevated increased damage with nearby enemies, take nearby enemies minus res, insane helmets, and nothing is even remotely as good as the Eye of Malice. The reason why the Eye of Malice is so good is because this build, in my current configuration, has minus 136 monster elemental resistance. Because we have two curses, we have Scorched Ground, we have Combustion, and we strong exposure, and probably some other sources I'm forgetting as well. Minus 136, right? Everything in the game, even an Uber that you rolled to have additional res, will still have negative res. And so even an Uber, right, Uber starts with 50 res, minus 136, so they are at negative 86 res. The 50% increased, the way that increase works, is it doesn't... Increase doesn't mean... It means increase the magnitude. Think of it as a vector. Think of it as an absolute value that then is multiplied by the, you know, by the sign on it, right? So the negative 86 multiplied times 1.5. Even an Uber boss will have negative 129 res. And any other normal monster that has lower res than that will actually hit the negative 200 res cap. However, Eye of Malice is not incredible for hardcore, right? There are very few defensive characteristics about it. It does have evasion, so you can use Spell Suppression Mastery. That could be nice. And, you know, if you want to lean into Ghost Shrouds or something like that, more power to you. If you are struggling to get this in Soul of Selfound, or if you want to get tankier, we can do something like this. I crafted this morning for very, very, very quickly. Technically, it cost me 2 Divines because I did do a Reforge with the Veiled Chaos Orb, but you could craft this total thing for much, much less than that. I bought this base for 1 Divine for perfect Fractured Spell Suppression, but you can go for anything else if you want to. You can go for Fractured Life, Fractured Res, and then you don't have to do this, I chose to craft this with Essence of Loathing. You could craft it with whatever else you want to, Essence of Envy for Chaos Res, whatever, but I just thought Essence of Loathing would be fun for Mana Reservation, and then I did Stuff Just Can't Be Changed, Veiled Chaos Orb, Unveiled Physical Damage Reduction while Focus. Even better would be a Hybrid Armor Evasion base, and then I took Fizz Taken as Fire, and Unique Enemy Increased Flammable Heat. Curse effect. This is like a non-damage helmet, but this is the direction that I would recommend if you're in hardcore. So we can get much more physical damage reduction, we can get more life, we have access to spell suppression much more comfortably. This is the direction that I would recommend. You can go that direction. We do lose a good amount of damage, but even with all of the less damage options, we can still stay in like the 10 to 20 million DPS range. You know, if you're in hardcore. Whatever fracture you want, just buy the cheapest fracture base that has a mod you care about. Use any essence you want, and just go for something like that on the implicit, and this will make you very, very tanky. And I want to present that as an option. Even tankier, and you're willing to sacrifice a little bit more damage here as well, is I would recommend going this direction. So this is like the cheap, tanky, like hardcore style option. Obviously, you know, I would prefer an armor base, but this is just what I happen to have. If you've ever played Righteous Fire, you know, with the fire trap and all those options, this is basically the direction that you would want to go. If you want to go like big CP, and actually the clear becomes better. Frostlink actually ends up with more damage when you do this. And you don't actually have to craft this helmet like this. This allows us to still get very solid damage by having a 7 link. I don't have the exact helmet right here because it is annoying to craft. It is not cheap, but this would be an aspirational thing that I would probably shoot for if I were in hardcore, is go for a helmet like this. So what I did here to craft this is this is a 6 link helmet. Right, it's 4 links plus burning damage plus trap and mind damage. This also gives us armor. We get, you know, we can get plus level of socketed gems. The ideal unveil veil would be +2, and then we can get additional life on the prefix there. This can make you, you know, nice and tankier on top of that. If you wanted to, you could even go for the PDR well focused mod that I have right there. To make this, to level this up even more, you can make this a 7 link, which if you crafted this with Essence of Horror, you get the socketed gems deal more elemental damage. And this is an example helmet that is not for this build, it's for the Righteous Fire setup, but it gives you an idea of what you can go for. Is you could do socketed gems, deal 30% elemental damage with an Essence of Horror until you hit, ideally, trap and mind damage. And then you can do Substances Can't Be Changed, Reforge Fire, and then go for burning damage as well. That will give you 3 sockets on the bottom, right? The socketed 30% more elemental, the burning damage, and the trap and mind damage, and then go for anything you want on the prefix. That will give you a pseudo 7 link in your helmet. You get really good damage. Just like a solid damage, it's not going to compare to Steel Lord. But you can go this direction if you want to play it hardcore. And then, the reason why we do this helmet is, I think we're done with the helmets. This is the segue into the body armors. You can go for body armor like this. So even better, actually, instead of the mana reservation efficiency of skills, would be the flat physical damage reduction. That's what I would actually recommend for even more PDR. But I crafted this really quick, and it's really pretty. I don't want to craft over it. This would be an aspirational body armor. This did not cost me very much to craft. So I bought the Fractured Spell Suppression, Fractured T2 Spell Suppression. this base that was already, I mean, you know, I bought it later on in the league, but this base that already had 5 white sockets and fractured 2 spell suppression, it was less than 5 divines. Since we have more spell suppression access here, you can go for fractured tier 3, you can go for a fractured anything, right? I just always want to make it clear. Anything fractured, you go for fractured essence life or anything. And then I crafted this with essences of loathing, which give us the mana reservation efficiency. The key and why I would recommend going this direction, if you are in the hardcore environment, is I'm currently not running grace. With my flask stuff, I have 55% evasion without grace, but if you really care about being, you know, in hardcore, right, I recommend running grace in addition, and it's not that hard to fit it in. Big part of that is because we're going to get the new mana preservation efficiency node right here, which is 12% global mana preservation efficiency. I am currently not even using an Enlighten. I took it out. With that mana reservation efficiency and using an Enlighten and crafting your helmet and your body armor with Essence of Loathing, you can fit in Grace in addition to all of the other auras that I'm already running, which is bonkers, right? So you can fit that in, and something like this, increased aura effect, all that type of stuff, especially if you go for a helmet. I currently have 5,400 life with a helmet and a body armor that have 0 life on them. This puts me over 6,000 life, just like this, right? And this isn't even min-max. You can become very resilient, you know, and then choose the helmet. You know, you can still 6-6 the fire trap in this body armor, or you can pseudo 6 or pseudo 7 link it in the helmet. And that would allow you to transition if you really cared and you care just about clearing and being absolutely crazy bonkers, mega, clear everything. I'm just going to comment on this very quickly. You can do something like single or double crafting a bronze life and just putting your frost blink in here. You can hit like a level 36 frost blink or something stupid like that. You can just unequip fire trap at that point, and frost blink is going to do everything except for, you know, end game bosses. This is not the way that I built this character, but if that's what you care about, you can just do that. Yeah, we can get 50% life, actually. That's a good point. We can use the new 15% life mastery. So you can get some life here as well. Really, really big evasion. So that's an option. So those are the non-Skin of the Lords alternatives. And there's also Dialis Malification. Dialis is really great because we care about the gem levels. The ideal body armor. This is peak performance. You might not like what it looks like. But the ideal body armor that I recommend is a Skin of the Lords with Eldritch Battery with the colors of 3 green, 2 red, and 1 blue. There's a good chance, and the main reason why I'm focusing so hard on body armors, there's a very, very good chance that they are particularly expensive next league due to the probably impending nerf of Devouring Diadem, you know, rarity. So Eldritch Battery is going to be even more desired. There's going to be, you know, if this build ends up being very popular, hopefully it is, if this build does end up being very, very popular, then, you know, everyone's going to be gunning for this item. And I want to make it very clear that as this is an SSF viable build, there are many, many alternatives, and you can do spectacular, great damage, become very defensive by, you know, taking advantage of other things. But this is the best. The reason why Skin Lords is the best, and it's very, very hard to compete with, is we get a Keystone. Eldritch Battery solves our mana entirely, right? As long as we have enough energy shield, then we don't care about mana cost. We don't have to go craft mana costs on our rings, mana costs on our amulet, da-da-da, you know. Fire Trap is a pretty expensive skill. Like, 103 mana for my Fire Trap, 100% solved with Eldritch Battery. That's one of the reasons. The other one is the 100% global defense is actually really nice. This gives me more armor, functionally, than even this body armor, actually. The 100% global is actually pretty wild. And then the big key here, and if you've ever played a League Starter spell skill, or you just want to scale your spells really easy, since spells scale so reliably and comfortably with gem levels, that's what we care about initially, right? Up until level 30, that's what we care about for a fire trap. Putting +2 level of all socketed gems with an empower makes empower level 6, you know, if it's level 4, so +5 socketed active gems, plus the fire trap getting the +2, and then the +2, and then the +6. Very, very easy for that, right? That's why Skin Lords is the best. We get the Eldritch Battery, we get the +2 level socketed. Now, the number one thing is our ideal links here are Fire Trap, Swift Affliction, Trap and Mind Damage, Burning Damage, Empower, and Combustion. That's our ideal setup, but we have a lot of flexibility. For the colors, we can use Efficacy, we can use Life Tap, actually. We can, we're already using Burning Damage. We can use Deadly Ailments. Deadly Ailments only work for the Ignite and not the Burning Ground, but it is still, it's a 55% more damage multiplier. It's not nothing to sneeze at. Or we could even toss in Ignite Proliferation support. And there may, there's probably other support things that I'm missing, but we are pretty resilient against the colors. We don't need these exact colors. They are the best, but there's other options. I do want to call out that we cannot use cruelty. Path of Building will tell you to use cruelty. Cruelty does not work on traps. It is a local buff for your character. It does not work for the trap, so don't use cruelty. That's the ideal body armor. I want to call out that there are a lot of different colors that we can use. We're very resilient to a lot of that, so mix and match. We can also do things. The Mage Bane is really, really good. Helps us cap our spell suppression. You know, we can do any keystone that doesn't break the build is okay. We can, you know, elemental overload. That's great. We can use, I wouldn't use Mind Over Matter. You get Runebinder is fine, right? We don't care about Runebinder is fine. Divine Shield is fine. Don't use Agnostic. Don't use Ego. Don't use Eternal Youth. The ones that clearly break the build, right? Unwavering Stance is great. You become stun immune. With Call to Arms, you can put Infernal Cry on your left click, and then you're good to go as well. There's so many options that are viable. Now, if mana becomes uncomfortable, what do I do? So you're going to need some unreserved mana. I took my mana as far as I could for reserving as much as possible, but, you know, precision, not necessary at all. You can drop precision, same thing with Flesh and Stone, not necessary at all, and then you actually get a decent mana boost, a mana buffer. And then all you really gotta do is there is this non-channeling mana cost right here. If you have that on both of your rings and an amulet, that's minus 21 on the mana cost. It makes a really, really big difference, and you're generally pretty comfortable. The other thing is you can just alternate your pathing. I was playing around with this a little bit earlier, is we were pathing down here, where, you know, we're grabbing these nodes. These nodes are not mandatory. They're nice, but they are absolutely not mandatory for the build. There is an alternate pathing that you can do that you could, like, you could skip all of these nodes, right? And then you could just path around the outside. That would allow you to take Eldritch Battery if you really wanted to. You could take Whispers of Doom, and you get down here, you still have access. Now, it is a little worse, but if you really want Eldritch Battery, it's not that much worse. These nodes are nice, but not mandatory whatsoever. That's an alternate pathing that you can do without really sacrificing the meat of the build. The meat of the, like, the way that this build works is the damage comes from over here primarily. Like, this is almost all the damage nodes. Down here, right, this is life, spell suppression, life, reservation, spell suppression, and a little bit of damage from Master Saturn. There's a lot of flexibility in this build. Like, really, as long as you have the nodes here and, you know, you have the nodes here, this is movable. The follow-up, the SSF-friendly version that I recommend as an alternative to a Dialas or a Skin Lords, this is the I want to go more damage option, that if Skin Lords are just way too expensive, if Dialas is too expensive early, and you want to be a little bit tankier, right? Because Dialas is just, like, it's a paper item, right? You can go for plus one level of socketed active gems with plus one level of socketed support gems. Okay, Warlord has active, Redeemer has support. However, if you are rolling this yourself with alterations, you want, what you want to see is you see this waiting, 250.4%. Ugh, cringe, yikes, ew. But if you look on an Elder item, you'll see that it has 0.65%. It's actually 50% easier to hit on an Elder mod, on an Elder base. Yeah, if you really care about the other mods here, Fizz, Taken As, anything like that, you can go for those bases. The other thing is you just search for the bases that just have that mod. It is generally not a very desired mod, and it's not hard to, like, I bought each of these bases for less than 20 chaos this morning. Just, like, no one cares. There are dozens of them. And you can alteration spam very, very easily for them as well. And then all you gotta do, you just use this magical little Awakener's Orb right here, and these are currently 90 to 100 chaos. Double influenced items are much less popular these days. It's not particularly expensive to make because of the rise of Eldritch bases. So all you do is, like, your better base, like, it doesn't matter which one, ensure that you only have one influence mod before you do this. So make sure there's one that says Shapers and only one that says Elders on this. You don't want, you know, if you see two Elder or two Shaper, then, you know, there's a 50-50 chance what it brings over. And then I got my better base here, the full dragon scale, so I want to keep that. So I click on the Conjurer's Vestment first, and then I click on the full dragon scale, and boom, look at that. I got Recover. That's actually pretty decent. Obviously, I would like more life or open anything, but I got Recover ES on kill. I got flat physical damage reduction. I get armor. I get evasion. I get the +1/+1, and it's very, very usable. Yeah, you could annul it, but this is going to make you tankier, actually, than a Skin of the Lords, and the damage is going to be pretty comparable. Skin of the Loyal is also okay. You can get a Skin of the Loyal and double corrupt them. Plus one socketed. It has the global defenses. It's the weaker version of a Skin of Lords that then you can use a Blessing of Traula and upgrade, which then is a risk, right? Because you don't know what keystone you're going to get. You could get Supreme Ego or something, and then you're very sad. No, he will not create a guide. It's all a lie.
I just threw away my ring. That I needed.
Yeah, I'm gonna. Guys, you have to be here right now. If you don't like, comment, subscribe, and sign up for Patreon and my OnlyFans and my Tinder and my Grindr right now, all of this content disappears. So be there. Get there right now. It's gonna disappear. There's a timer. Uh oh, guys. It's about that OnlyFans. What am I posting? Hey, whatever you asked for. So next up is we'll do the jewelry. Jewelry's actually really, really easy with this build. The easiest thing right off the rip is we can use the pyre. Pyre is great. It rolls from 60 to 80% increased burning damage, and then by using elemental damage catalysts, we can get that up to 96% increased burning damage. The other really nice thing about the pyre is since it has cold damage converted to fire damage, that will make our Frostblink do more fire than cold damage, because like even though it's only 48% conversion, because we're scaling increased fire damage, it scales that fire damage way higher than the cold damage. You know, we want a mouse or a Frostlink, make sure it's doing more fire damage than cold damage to get that bigger ignite. And then with the pyre, we actually don't need cold to fire. And you can do something, you can do efficacy, you can do any of these other ones, you can link life tap, whatever. Burning damage is fine. Burning damage is also, like I said, burning damage is a rectangle. Ignite is a square. We'll scale both the burning ground for fire.
The fuck? This was in the thing?
So it's just really, really
I'm scared bad. To take it
I
now.
I do not recommend Barracks Respite. I talked about this a little while ago. The way that Ignite Prolif works, the gem itself, Ignite Proliferation, is the enemy that dies on the ground will still be burning, and enemies that walk over it will...
It's a lot of strength that I don't have.
It'll spread within the radius of 20, and it will stay there for a duration. Even after the monster dies, it'll stay there on the ground. Whereas Barracks Respite, it will proliferate. So, like, if it's dense, Barracks Respite is better because it'll constantly proliferate. As soon as the monster dies, if there isn't a monster next to that death, that proliferation is also over. I do not like Barracks. But anyway, Pyre's kind of mid as well. It's very, very, you know, it's a one alchemy ring, but it is kind of mid. Great starter. You can even use two Pyres if you want to. But better than that is something like this. These are very, very easy to make. I actually have the perfect two examples for the two ways that you want to craft this. So this is the better one, and then this is the cheaper one. Where is it? Increased fire damage right here. So these are the two ways that you would want to craft rings right here. Is you can use a... Just buy a fractured base. Hit it with some resistance catalyst, and then I hit it with some essences of anger until I was happy with the suffixes. You can buy fractured chaos res. You can buy fractured anything, right? Look for something that you care about. Hit it with a couple essences of anger until you got nice mods. Craft whatever else on it, and you're good to go. Like, this total ring cost was like 60 chaos. This is nothing. And two of these will just feel really good. Good res, decent damage, nice to go. And then this is the better, more expensive version. What we did here is I used Essence of Horror to craft the this ring right here. This is with Fertile Catalyst for the life and mana modifiers. It's, you know, the base was still really cheap. Like, this is a very, very cheap ring, you know, still like, you know, 20, 30, 40 chaos. Hit it with Essences of Horror. It was actually just the damage over time multiplier and the lightning res. I did suffixes can't be changed and a veiled chaos orb. I'm a very big fan of veiled chaos orbs. It makes crafting very, very quick. I didn't care if I got a veiled prefix or a suffix, just whatever, you know, spent two divines. And I unveiled endurance charges and endurance charge on kill. And I craft increased damage, and that's it. So, like, the total cost of this ring, 2.5 divines. This is, like,
there's my strength problem.
Ring. Like, this is the cheaper one. You know, this is, like, 100 chaos max, and this is, like, 2.5 divines. And that's really all you need to do for your rings. It's super, super easy. And so that's the rings there. And then, like I said, if you don't have Eldritch Battery...
I craft strength on it. I could probably use it.
Skills minus mana cost. And that's it. Super, super easy. So... This is a very nice amulet.
Doesn't have strength.
20, 25 divines. It just
I have
really
80
deep,
strength.
And I wanted to have something pretty awesome for a showcase.
I need 33.
As I explained earlier, with my current setup, I have a level 30
and fire trap. Actually, there's 30.
Stark diminishing
returns. I can make that 33.
Fire trap for,
I'll have
for
to craft.
And we can demonstrate this very, very easily. If you look at the damage right here, fire trap 2.
Yeah, there we go.
5, 6, 7. Fire damage per second. That's only the burning ground. It's not the fire damage. And this is, you know, it's like a 20 to 30 divine amulet. It's really, really nice. It's a
I don't like
cool
those stats.
I bought this fractured base this morning for 150 chaos. Mm. I just hit it with scorch fossils until I hit fire skill gems and increased fire damage. Just scorch fossils on a fractured damage over time base that has 150 until I hit fire skill gems and anything else that I liked. Look at the damage. 2.56 million.
Shitty res.
2.56 million. That's the diminishing returns on the gem levels. It's almost identical. So the dot multi is giving us as much damage as the plus gem level. This is absolutely overkill. Mm-hmm. You don't need it. Mm-hmm. You can just do something like this. And like previously, anything fractured on the amulet, right? If you get fractured level of all fire, or you get fractured increased fire, or anything like that, fractured life even, hit it with scorch fossils, hit something like this. If you really want to preserve as many ores as possible, be more
pretty bad.
You can always just use an ashes. Ashes is totally fine. Obviously, for many reasons, I'm not recommending that in the league starter, but it's a fine amulet. Really relieves a lot of mana pressure and, you know, yada yada. But obviously not that, that's not the recommendation to go for. Really, just find dot multi and plus one fire. You can craft it yourself, and it's really all you need, right? Like,
oh, I have to be level 62. I didn't even fucking see that.
What did I say? Like one divine this morning?
Oh my
yeah,
god.
This is great, right? It's almost,
or at least I can use my, I had to.
Really, really nice one. So next up is the glove.
Get strength
welcome
anyways.
In modern Path of Exile. For anything that doesn't require very, very specific influence mods or anything like that, this is how you craft in PoE. If there's one thing you need to take away from this is buy a fractured base. You don't have to buy the exact fractured base. Fractured bases are super common. You don't have to buy the exact one that I have. You don't have to follow what's on exactly on the guide. With this, right, I could, any of those mods, obviously two of those are not dropped, but any of those mods, if they're fractured, fractured lightning res, if I hit that, I'm happy. Fractured life, you can get even more life. Fractured life, that's great. And then, since this is an essence craft, this is the high-end version. You don't need the socketed high-end version, but this is with an essence of delirium right here. What this does is it has socketed gems deal 30% more damage. We have this in our gloves right here. All I did was I bought the fractured base with spell suppression. I think I hit this in like one or two essences. I hit some spell suppression. Then I did suffixes can't be changed, as always, veiled chaos orb. And then I, then you craft conversion on gloves. Before the unveil, you craft conversion to block one of the conversions. That's the highest weight. Convert, you know, fizz to cold, anything like that. Doesn't matter which one you craft. I unveiled physical damage reduction while focused. You can go for whatever you want. You know, socketed gem. Socketed gems is probably the best, socketed AoE gems. That's probably the best unveil for Frostblink damage. And that makes the ignite from the Frostblink deal 30% more damage. It's a pseudo 5 link. That's all we're going for. And you can start lower level without the essence of delirium. Buy a fractured base. Doesn't matter if it has life on it.
I don't know why I'm watching this. Do-do-do-do. Made it in 40. Well, these are all short. Huh. Stardew Valley? Huh. Sounds nice. Five decks. Away. Left. Oh my. That was fast. Their portal. Do I have something for this? What do I do? Oh, I have to go here. Does it not jump over the wall? Well, I've jumped over so many walls like that. Talk to Helena all of a sudden, randomly? Oops. Doesn't die. What the fuck? One tanky fucker, man. I got him. I can't curse you. Where do you access the... The fuck? That would be there. Oh, here it is. No? Crossword? Is this where I came from? I'm confused. Maybe not. Wait, no, I backtracked. I'm confused. Where's the Chamber of Sins 2? Am I tripping? Is it that way? It looks exactly like the other side. Except the there was no purple to dissipate. Thank you. 43 sulfite, eh? That's crazy. Crazy low, yeah. It's a ripoff. Where am I going? This way? Last way. supposed to get a barrier of rocks too. What? Barrier of rocks? I don't know what that is. Talking about in game? I have no idea. I'm just getting fireflies. Is that the door? But when it tells me to get a barrier of rocks, I will have to do it, I guess. I don't know. Never heard of that before, though. I'm tripping now. I don't know. I don't remember everything. He was jumping and having that. Maybe a had an hallucination. No, that's an MTX. MTX is microtransaction. It's an abbreviation for microtransaction, which means cosmetic. You see. It just does a spike around the circle of this consecrated ground here. It's a microtransaction, MTX, cosmetic, for looks. That's why when you see these people that are showing off their builds, they have all their cosmetics on, which they shouldn't. First, I think as a guy who's trying to show off his build, to people he should be taking off his cosmetics for his skills. No, I don't think so. I'm pretty sure. So there's cosmetics for skills. Everything has a cosmetic in this game. If you want to buy it, you can buy it. You don't have to. It's just... But it's there. Like auras? Like these auras I have on? They're doing this circle around me? They can look different. What do I have on? Like malevolence? Where's the search bar? Where's the search bar? Oh, there it is. How do you look at all? Where's all? I guess I don't do it. Anyways, skill effects. Malevolence. No? There's no skill of. Is that not a skill effect? That's interesting. What do I do? Fire trap? Where's the video playing? Hello? Oh, that's fire trap. Yeah. No, what do I do? What was the skill we're trying to do? It was the jump one, right? What's it called? No. Is it frost blink? Maybe it's frost blink. Or what's the other one? Leap slam. Oh, slam. Leap slam. And none of those look like it, eh? Sometimes, I don't know. Also, it could be, maybe there's special ones that aren't in the shop to buy. That were maybe in a special, they're in a special bundle. Too, it's possible. But I don't know. Maybe you're right, maybe there's some weird... Oh, here it is. Nope, that's it. Frost Blink. 110. That's it. That would have been fun if it do some damage. That would be pay to win. Personally, I find cosmetics kind of at a disadvantage because of how much clutter it makes your screen. You can't see as much. You don't know really what's going on sometimes with all the clutter. I don't really like cosmetics that much. These guys have this huge outfit on with all these auras that are huge and all over the place around their character with a big bubble, and then they have skills that do these huge blah 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 blah, blah happening. And you can't see anything. I don't know, but that's, I guess, personal preference. Whatever, if you want to buy it, you can buy it. Which is cool, man. The amount of cosmetics that they have in this game, all the time, coming out, new, is amazing. It's amazing that it's there. You know, people love it. People, you see Apex, people eat cosmetics up in Apex, and they're trash. Cosmetics are gas. I mean, not gas, they're ass. But people love them. People act weird. I don't know, the Apex community is odd. I keep my mouth shut about it. People have their opinions, so it's whatever, but I don't know, man. funny. So bad. So minimal. It's so ass. Everyone says it too. Everyone says it's trash. They still buy it. I don't know. Through it all.
That would just make life complicated.
Don't you doubt, Tom. Remember, humanity needs us.
I could probably do the first trial. The first trial now.
Thank you.
die to these traps. Die of the traps. Where's my ascendancy? I clicked the thing, right? Where's your ascendancy thing? Where is it attached to? Is it attached to here? I clicked the shrine before I left. Did I do something wrong? Was I supposed to actually... I remember just all you have to do is click the shrine. Top of the tree. Oh no, is it different for, witch? I thought it was connected to this. I fucked up? Damn. It's here somewhere. I'm just missing it. I don't understand. You're playing witch, right, Rainbow? Where do you go to see the ascendancy?
That would just make life complicated.
About to do it again? The fuck? Sucks. I clicked the wall, man. That's all you have to do. I watched some video told me that's all you have to do. Just make sure you click the wall and you're good. You can apply the nodes later. All you have to do is click the wall. Click the wall and it tells the game that you've done it. I swear to God, that's what someone told me. All you have to do is click the wall. Click the wall. You can apply the passives later. Literally, that's what they said. Which makes sense. Like, you get a skill point. You can apply this once you level up. You get the skill point. You can't de-level. You can use the... You can use the skill point whenever you want. That's just how it works. It makes fucking sense. I click the wall, the ascendancy wall. I don't understand. Stupid. I wanted to make sure I got that trade because it was ADC for a flask that I made. To actually sell. I made a couple flasks to sell. I thought they would sell, and they do sell. Like, It has 25% reduced mana cost of skills as a craft on it. There's flask crafts that you can do. A suffix flask craft. In the crafting bench, and you can only get them from you can learn the craft from unveiling unique flasks. Like, there's only one, and it's the unique flask from where you fight the safe house mastermind. You get drop them, and I needed the flask for my build, right? So I purchased one that needed an unveil. For like ADC or something, and I got lucky, and I unveiled it, and that the one I needed was there, so I unlocked the skill, the craft, and then I realized that they kind of sell for a lot, the craft, like on a good bottle with a good tier one prefix, right? So you got level 85 flask, and that people want usually, a common one. That's that people use in almost all their builds for the most part, and then you get a good prefix only with no suffix on the flask, and then you craft 25% reduce mana costs of skills. And you, and then you look at the market for that flask, which is like 90C. 90C for the flask. And then you... Is this the right way? I swear it changed, man. And then you just mark it down 10C. So you're at the you're at the top. You're the cheapest one. Or you're gonna be, if unless somebody else outdoes you, but then eventually that guy will be bought out and then you'll be the bot, you'll be the cheapest for that flask, and then people will just buy your flask because it's the cheapest. And it took like 10 seconds, it took like 2 minutes to make. So I made like 3 of them and they all sold now. With I made 3 of them because I only had 3 flasks that in my inventory already without purchasing, like going out of my way to purchase a flask. Had 3 like in my flask stash that I had, so I just grabbed those 3, quickly made 3 flasks to see if they would sell, and they did. So really make money. Learning stuff. Next leg I'll be like, no, I don't think I'm going the right way. Alright, back here again. That didn't take too long. First trial's easy. Get better chests. Wait, did everything disappear except for the treasure chest? Weird. Didn't happen last time. Wow, go hide boots. I think I did ascend it. I don't know why it's not. Why it didn't let me click the, like, choose the things. I don't know which ones I do. Does it matter? You had to click ascend button. Oh. For it to come up. Once you do this once, click the ascend button in your special class. Then all you have to do when you come in here for the next time is just click this and you can leave and then do it later. I said, fucking, how am I? Okay, there I learned something. I had more keys? Who knew? They'll disappear. Oh, because I clicked the button. That's why they disappear. I clicked the button I put somewhere I never click. I hid the button. I don't know why I don't just turn the button off. What a button. I hate this button. Highlight. Toggle highlighted. So dumb. Know how to get rid of it. Stupid thing. No! Stupid. So what did I get in my ascendancy? I don't even know. Damage multiplier. Hits always ignite. All damage can ignite. It's which for which the highest damage type is fire. Alright, I'm gonna go. See ya!